Everyone, myself Meenu Das, and here I will be giving an introduction on how to determine the coefficient of discharge of a venturi plume practically. So a venturi plume is a critical flow open plume with a constricted flow which causes a drop in the hydraulic grade line, creating a critical depth. And coefficient of discharge is the ratio of actual discharge to the theoretical discharge. The determination of coefficient of discharge depends on Venturi principles, which states that by reducing the cross-sectional area of channel gradually will result in increase in velocity. The procedure is given here. The channel is first set to mild slope using screw jack. The slope is checked using the depth gauge to establish the change of depth over 4 meter length with static water retained in the channel. The venturi plume is to be fitted. The measure the width of the channel and of the throat of the plume using internal calipers and a steel rule. Water is admitted to the channel by opening the control. Then measure the upstream depth with condition of supercritical flow downstream of the throat. Then the discharge is measured using measuring tank. Then reduce the flow in steps and record the discharge and the depth at each stage. The equipments required are open channel, scale, stopwatch and venturi plume. Now we can calculate the coefficient of discharge using these equations. So here the cross-sectional diagram of venturi plume is shown. Two sections are marked, section 1 at the upstream side of the plume and section 2 at the throat of the plume. At the throat, the area decreases. So the area at section 1 can be found out by B into Y, where B is the venturi plume width at section 1 and Y is the depth of flow at section 1. Similarly, at section 2, the area can be found out by considering the width of the plume at section 2 and depth of flow at section 2. Then theoretical discharge can be found out using the equation A1 into A2 root over 2gh divided by square root a1 square minus a2 square. So where h is the head difference. After that, the actual discharge can be found out from the discharge through the channel. Then the coefficient of discharge can be found out by dividing actual discharge by theoretical discharge. Then the observation table is plotted, where we put the values of theoretical discharge and actual discharge and calculate the coefficient of discharge. From the coefficient of discharge, we can easily find out the average coefficient of discharge, so which is the required result. That's all. Thank you.